on to agenda item 9, vacancies. Agenda item 9, the Assistant Director for Law and Governance has been notified of changes to council committees as indicated on the contents pages of the agenda. Council is requested to note changes to the membership of committees and outside bodies and provide nominations for any current vacancies as follows. Committee appointments, Environment Overview and Scrutiny Committee, Councillor Tony Smith to replace Councillor Joe Walsh. Outside body appointments, Merseyside Police and Crime Panel, Councillor Tony Smith to replace Councillor George Davies. Liverpool City Region Combined Authority Scrutiny Panel, Councillor Tom Anderson be appointed as Conservative representative to the panel. Vacancies, Merseyside Society for the Deaf, Councillor David Burgess-Joyce to replace Councillor David Elton. Are all those changes approved, Council? Thank you. Councillors, we now turn to item 10 on pages 73 of 256 to 256 of the Council agenda, which includes recommendations from Licensing Act 2003 Committee, 15th of March 2017, and Employment and Appointments Committee, 27th of June 2017. Items requiring approval of the Council. Firstly then, item A on page 73 of the agenda, 10A, Licensing Act 2003 Committee, 15th of March, Special Cumulative Impact Policy. I now invite Councillor Bill Davis, Chair of the Licensing Act 2003 Committee, to move the recommendations as contained in the agenda front sheets and pages 73 to 105 of your agenda papers. Thank you. Is there a seconder? Thank you. All those in favour of the recommendation in respect of agenda item 10A, please clearly indicate. The recommendation of that is carried. Thank you very much. I'm now turning to item B on page 107 of the agenda, 10B, Employment and Appointments Committee, 27th of June 2017, Recruitment of Chief Officer Posts and Structure Changes. I now invite Councillor Phil Davis to move the recommendation as contained in the agenda front sheets on pages 107 to 119 of your agenda papers.
Second.
Is there a seconder? Thank you. Notice has been given of two amendments in respect of this item. They are set out on pages 17 and 19 of the agenda supplement. I therefore call upon the movers and seconders of the amendments to please so indicate.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Madam Mayor, it was extremely disappointing that at the Employment and Appointments Committee on the 27th of June, that once again this council was proposing that.
Sorry, Councillor Wright, can you just stop you there? I'm just taking minutes and seconds to move.
Oh, sorry, so
it's in the
Yes,
sorry. So you're moving on. Second. Second amendment.
Continues to work. proposes that some senior officers are paid more than the Prime Minister of this country, whoever that Prime Minister may be. Excuse me, Madam Mayor. Madam Mayor, we have been informed in the past that we have to pay huge salaries to attract the best people. And that continues, obviously, to be the mindset of the leadership of this council. Unfortunately, past history shows us that when we have done that, when we have appointed senior officers on exorbitant salaries, we haven't always been successful in retaining those officers. What was again then further disappointing, Madam Mayor, was that if you counted up the present structure of the Chief Executive and then the proposed new structure, there was no reduction in the number of Chief Officers. That certainly cannot be right, Madam Mayor, when we are now a council in the north of England that has, for one reason or another, over a number of years, reduced the number of employees that we have. It seems completely wrong that the number of senior officers' appointments has not reduced accordingly. So therefore, Madam Mayor, with that disappointment, it brought us to have to move this amendment here tonight. And therefore, we would propose, Madam Mayor, to amend the council chief officer's pay as set out in the council's pay policy to incorporate a maximum cap of the proposed salary for the director of children's service, which is less than the prime minister of the day's salary. And also, Madam Mayor, we would request that the chief executive either scrap or reconsider his proposal to create a new director of strategy and partnerships, again, a salary well over £100,000
plus employee costs. Thank you, Madam Mayor. Thank you, Councillor Gilchrist. You now have 5 minutes to review your amendment.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. We raise this not because of any churlish attitude or any pinching attitude or savings attitude, but because we were convinced by the case for the salary that was being put forward. The previous director is recorded on the council website as receiving over £115,000. And the question went through our minds at the panel where we were given a long list of alternative councils with sums of money alongside the posts being appointed. I spent some time trying to compare our case with the case that those other places might have. And of course, we all operate in the light of the Ofsted report, the light of Ofsted taking a further line of councils across the country, and with the, shall we say, goalposts or bar being raised for what Ofsted expects. But it was still not possible to make a judgment on the figures we had about how we compared to the other councils listed. Sometimes it used to be a question that perhaps the size of the or its population, or the extent of the area, or its other aspects of management structure were key factors in choosing the projected proposed salary. However, I didn't have that information on the night, and despite having a discussion with senior officers elsewhere, I still remained unconvinced about the jump in the proposed salary. We are being told that we need to work in this particular competitive market. Perhaps I'm getting rather old-fashioned, but I believe in public service, and I do look forward to eventually appointing an officer who is totally committed to the needs of the children in the borough after we've been through difficult times as a council. And it might be that our reputation as a borough, or our reputation perhaps as a series of officers that have come and gone, might influence applicants. I don't know. So we're going to see the applicants and see what they're saying about what they want to achieve here. On the issue of, shall we say, how do we keep track? How do members keep track of the very senior officers? In 2013, the corporate plan ran through 17 pages, and in it, it proposed a new performance appraisal and development program, which starts with the chief executive, strategic directors, directors and heads of service, and will be rolled out to senior managers across the council. Well, in the last year or so, we had some difficulty following the appraisal process as it went through officers in the other ranks. We
also found at various times that payables were not being particularly completed on time or being worked. So, having started at the top, we also want to make sure that the people at the top are being thoroughly appraised. So if anyone is appointed and people are appointed, they will look very carefully for what their performance actually is as time goes on. The panel also discussed a number of issues which we accept, which I don't refer to in the amendment, but the minutes for that latter part of the meeting were produced in the supplement. And so, Madam Mayor, I suggest the course of action in the amendment that I move and hope Council will support.
Thank you, Mr.
Councillor
Adrian Jones, you now have
up
to 3 minutes to
address the meeting. Thank you, Madam Mayor. I haven't said that I'm particularly amused at the way in which this has been brought before us. The use of the comparator of the Prime Minister for a highly skilled job, which requires our council to have somebody in position who we can absolutely rely on, not to make a complete mess of everything they do, and I suggest that we don't want to be making that comparison at all. Do you honestly think that if the Prime Minister were to apply for a post, then this council, for any of the jobs we've got advertised, or anything we won't be like them, I can tell you that as long as I'm the chair of the Budget Appointments Committee, I don't think she can get more shortlisted. To make that sort of comparison, but it's all that there has been benchmarking undertaken professionally for us to make comparisons with all of the other authorities that we can bring into the benchmarking exercise. I would say, I think with your personal point of view on this, I think that those sort of posts are, across the whole country, overpaid, very severely overpaid. But we are caught up in the aftermath of the greed culture of, I mentioned the sainted lady, of the Thatcher years, where these sort of inflated salaries are outwitted and matched only by the grossly greedy gifts of the Tory government has been given to people with their tax refunds alone. This is Melson's very clean significance in comparison. But no, the plain fact is, if Mrs. May applied for the job here, she wouldn't get it, and it's silly to make that comparison with her wages.
Thank you, Mr. Jones. Councillor Tom Anderson, you now
have up to 3 minutes. Thank you, Madam Mayor. I just want to make a few observations on the structure as a whole of the event. In October last year, I questioned whether the so-called new operating model was fit for purpose, whether it needed further thoughts, and I was prompted to ask this after the Chief Executive had already unveiled what we shall refer to as new operating model version 1. It had four executive level officers grouped around themes of strategy, business delivery, and transformation, all well and good it seemed. However, version 1 lasted about 3 weeks when Ofsted put a hole in the middle of it, when it was discovered that it was, in fact, unable to guarantee improvements in their children's services, given that the services for children were incomprehensibly split between strategy management and delivery management. And that point had been made at the Employment Committee by across the spectrum. So we had a little bit of what we should call our new operating model version 2. That was put before us with an additional executive level director for all children-related functions. And at that stage, we were still told that once children's services were where we wanted them to be, the model would revert back from 5 executive level directors to the 4 envisaged in operating model version 1. Now clearly things have developed. Here we are 8 months on from version 2, and we have in front of us new operating model version 3. It now has 6 executive level officers sitting below the Chief Executive. So I assume we have abandoned the hope that we can move back to a more streamlined executive management structure. It seems that the Chief Executive had not in fact put in place the right people in the right roles at that point, and the operation of the operating model has now collapsed. It seems to me that the only area in this council where the staff employed is expanding is at executive level, whilst the front line is left to struggle with fewer people. There is no justification, Madam Mayor, for the split in business and corporate resource functions as is proposed. A corporate resource is very clearly a business service, and it should be managed as such. My own view is that version 3 is still a mishmash. It's not been designed with the needs of the organisation in mind. It's a mess. Probably not last the 8 months that version 2 was in done for, and I'd ask the leader to recognise this, take it back, and bring us a management structure that's designed to deliver cost-cutting, flexible and efficient services that I think the public wish us to deliver.
Thank you, Councillor Kelly.
I really had a lost lesson to why we're taking this approach. You see, we definitely need the Director of Children's Services. And it's a legal requirement, yeah, and our children deserve the best. You've seen the benchmark. I agree with what Adrian's just said. They are paid too bloody much. The fact is, that's what they are paid. The benchmark says that's what they're paid. But in similar situations, in other areas of the council, if our children are going to have the best, we're going to have to pay that amount of money. And I don't know whether it's political scoring or what it is, but our children deserve the best. And we're going to have to pay the best. And that's what I'm standing here. I'm going to stand up and support our children. And I'm hoping that across, from the minute I took this portfolio, I said, it's all our responsibility. I will always say it's all our responsibility. So we should all want the best. And if the best costs are 140 to 150 grand, you can look across the whole country. This council is not doing anything that other councils aren't doing. All we're doing is we're in the middle of a competitive market. And if we want the best, I'm afraid we're going to have to pay for it.